Sam here, do it for the kit. Down here in Puerto Vallarta right now. We're staying at the Marriott Hotel in Marina Vallarta. Super nice little resort, pretty cool. But anyway, I've been trying to find a sweet day hike that we could do.
All right, here is a map of Puerto Vallarta that we got from the hotel. And we're just gonna show you an overview of an option for a really cool day hike to a place where you can go scuba diving. So you'll be starting in the Marina Vallarta Hotel.
Take a short walk from your hotel in the Marina Vallarta to the highway. From the highway, you catch the central bus. Follow the central bus all the way to somewhere in this neighborhood. You'll have to then change to the Boca De Tomatlan bus. And you take that bus down to Boca De Tomatlan, where you will walk, where you'll get off the bus, you'll walk through a small village, you'll cross a bridge, and then you have a 2-hour hike along the yellow road, the yellow brick road, down to Las Animas for your scuba or snorkeling pleasures. When you're finished, you'll catch the water taxi down here at Las Animas. You'll hail him down, and then you'll follow him back up to Boca de Tomatlan and go back on the same route to the hotel that you started from.
All right, so this is my kit that I'll be wearing today on the Puerto Vallarta day hike. Not a lot of stuff necessary. I got my GoPro here attached to my chest strap for quick access. I got the REI Flash 22 backpack. I really like it, and it's a super affordable piece of kit. Probably, I mean, I don't think you can do better for a day pack. If you want to spend the money, sure, go ahead. But this thing, when it was on sale, cost me about $25. Got just 1 liter of water, a pack towel instead of a beach towel, just like a medium-sized pack towel. Inside I got my Crocs, and that's about it, really. For shoes, I'm wearing the Leadville V3s. I'm gonna go barefoot in them, see how that works out. But yeah, I got the Salomon running shorts with a mesh liner, so no underwear. G-Shock Rangeman as always, and the Colombian Ridgeline or Colombian Silverlight shirt, which I love. I've been wearing it the whole time I've been here in Puerto Vallarta. So here I got the Oakley Flak 2.0 sunglasses, which I'm obsessed with. Favorite pair of sunglasses I've ever had. Although I don't usually take them on hikes because I just love them so much. They're more of just like my, you know, at-home wear. But for those, I do have a whatever you call this thing. So this is the kit I'll be wearing on just a normal day hike. Okay, so we were gonna take the bus, but the females in my family decided that a taxi might be a better option. And you know what? Frankly, I agree. The taxi is gonna be a lot more efficient. So the bus is gonna be 40 cents per person all the way down to Boca de Tomatlan, and the taxi is only $14. So we're gonna go with the taxi and get there quicker.
So we vouched for the taxi ride, and here is kind of the view. You can see the mountains up front. Anyway, it's about a... How long is the taxi ride? Minutes?
Maybe 35 minutes.
It's about a half hour, 40 minute taxi ride.
Alright, we just made it to the town of Boca de Tomatlan. I'll show you guys kind of what the town looks like before we head off into the hike. Okay, so we just got out of the taxi and we're here at Boca de Tomatlan. Amazing little town. Never really seen anything like it. The taxi ride took about an hour, taxi driver said there was a bit of traffic, so anyway, glad we took the taxi because I'm guessing the bus would have been about 2 hours. So here's the town and we're going to find the trailhead and I'll keep you guys posted. Here in Boca de Tomatlan, we located the bridge and there's some signs. So here's the bridge that you want to go down to start on your hike.
With his snorkel equipment.
Oh,
sweet little lookout feature right here.
Yeah.
One thing, there's a lot of handrails on this trail, but there's also barbed wire fence. So just careful not to grab onto that and mistake it for a handrail. Again, more signs directing you towards your destination, Calamitos. So I would say that this trail is extremely easy to follow and to, you're not gonna get lost. My sister has a very interesting piece of kit on right now. She calls them Aladdin pants. They have a few other names, but basically what these do is they create a tornado-like effect of wind and breathability coming through the thigh gap. So really cool piece of kit. You can get it on the down low for about 50 pesos, and yeah, you'll find those very useful. Okay, so here we are at Calamitos, our first stop. It was pretty quick getting here, maybe about a 30-minute hike, you know, if you're stopping and taking pictures. Our next stop is Los Anos. As you can see, this is, you know, a fairly crowded beach, a lot of people here, so hopefully Los Anos will be a better spot, but this is a really sweet water hole, definitely a cool place to get down. Here's a better look at Calamitos. And we are going to go up these stairs to get to Los Anos. Pretty sick kind of wildlife behind me, some sweet plant life, some vines that I might swing from, we'll see, but like that one right there looks pretty swing worthy. But a cool thing about this trail so far is I've actually had 3 bars of reception this whole time, which is kind of crazy. I even just received and picked up a FaceTime call. Again, just a really well-made trail. Lots of steps and handrails. So for older folk or, you know, people with nagging injuries, really doable trail. Porque si me salta un gallo, no me le rajo a la muerte. Ay, 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 mamá por Dios. Porque es que borracho vengo, que me siga la tambora, que me toque en el quelite. Después el niño perdido y por último el torito, pa' que vean cómo me pinto. Ay, 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 mamá por Dios. Hearing a lot of cool bird noises, a lot of, you know, it sounds like there's a lot of life going on in this jungle. A lot of birds chirping and some unfamiliar bird sounds.
Ay, Colima, de ti me estoy acordando.
Okay. So, we didn't quite make it to Los Anos because it was getting late and we weren't sure about the water taxi schedule, but anyway, we stopped at a really cool beach. There it is. Do a little snorkeling. And all in all, really great day hike. Alright, pulling into Boca De Tomatlan in our water taxi. Beautiful day. Where we started the hike. There we are. What a day.